Since the beginning of time in video games, people have been jumping on and off platforms. But there was one knight in starched white pajamas who changed the way we look at video games forever. Prince of Persia was brutal, engaging, entertaining, and above all, intensely rewarding. It was the first game I ever completed on my own. Well, actually, with a little help of my 8-year-old sister. Set in ancient Persia, where the Sultan is away fighting battles in a faraway land, the daughter is the only soul stopping the evil Grand Vizier Jafar from taking full control of the kingdom. But Jafar screws things up by capturing the princess and, in a totally original move, locks her up in the tower in the palace. The game's protagonist, the prince, has to navigate through the dungeons to the tower and rescue her. Oh, and the player has to do all this within an hour, because otherwise the princess is gonna marry the most eligible bachelor in town, Jafar. While being the knight in linen armor, the prince has to find his way through various swordsmen, skeletons, guillotines, spike traps, pits, and in one instance, his own reflection. Its tricky sword duels and death traps have since become legendary. The creator Jordan Mechner was a huge fan of the Arabian Nights stories, like all the cool kids in school. He also got hugely influenced by the first 10 minutes of the Raiders of the Lost Ark, which kinda explains why this game is a mashup of cliches of all these stories, but hey, who actually played it for the story anyway? People did play it for the graphics, and it was a giant leap forward in terms of animation for video games. Mechner studied many hours of footage of his brother David running and jumping around in white clothes. Talk about method acting. He then took the footage and traced over it to create the incredibly smooth animation for the game. The style also aided in the gameplay, leading the player to get their timing just right in order to complete a jump, attack, or defend. It was all about precision. Miss the edge by an inch, and you would plummet to your certain gory death. Ah, how I hated that sound. The game was notoriously difficult to play at many levels, but at the same time took the usual platforming element of, you know, going through a level with 3 lives and turned it around by adding the time factor. Now the objective was to learn shortcuts and the fastest way of doing things rather than conserve lives. What all this also meant was the game, released on almost every platform available, was able to sell millions and inspire a long line of sequels and even a movie. Now all these did well in their own right, but never did, nor will, be able to match the impact the original game made. Add to that the nostalgia and the sense of achievement you got when you finally figured out how to deal with your Nega Prince, kill Jafar, or that mouse that opened that trap door for you. Prince of Persia stays with you long after you're done playing it, just like how the best game should.
This is Gamatorium, and you are just going to become our newest subscriber.
Please, please subscribe, please. Papi, paid ka sawal and all that.
Papi to zarur hai.
Paid bhi hai.
Haan, paid hai. Do billiyan hai. Paid cat. Please subscribe.
Not now.
Somewhere here.